Hello, dear student. Today I am here to start a new subject with you all, and the subject is Principles and Practices of Management. Before starting this, let me introduce myself. I am Dr. Priyanka Rana, Associate Professor in School of Commerce and Management, IIMT University, and I'll be taking you forward on the journey of this Principles and Practices of Management. I welcome you all here. And I hope that my sessions will help you out in understanding this subject in a detailed manner and in an easy manner also. So let's start. We'll cover the five units or the five chapters of the subject. The very first chapter of this subject is Introduction to Management. Now, in this introduction, what are the objectives of the chapter are going to be, what we are going to start our as under. First of all, we will start or we will understand the management concepts. Then we'll study the characteristics of management. The third is functions of management. And the fourth part of this chapter is going to be the principles of management. We'll start with the very first thing, that is understanding management concepts. Now, first of all, we should understand what is management. How do you define management? What management is basically, how it is associated with you all, with us all, in our lives, in our organizations, in our personal lives, in our professions. What it is, why management is very important, why we are studying this subject. So to understand, we should have an overview of what management is. Management is the attainment of organizational goals in an effective and efficient manner through planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling organizational resources. Every business needs planning for the future, for a successful business, and the person who is in the authority has to take decisions and be responsible for the consequences of his decisions, whether favorable or unfavorable. Organizational resources include men, human beings, money, machine, and materials. Management is what a manager does within the organization. All the activities, whether related to decision making or implementation, are performed by the managers to achieve common. Now, to be in a simple sense, if I'll explain what management is, so management is basically essential in all the organized efforts. If you want your efforts to be organized, you need to be managed. Whether it is a business activity or any other activity, it is your personal activity, it is your organizational activity, you need to be managed. And the principles for this management are given by Henry Fayol are the universal principles. Although we are going to discuss these principles later on in the last part of this sub chapter, but there are certain principles that needs to be followed. And if you'll see that it is management is applicable everywhere, whether it is the education institution, whether it is some social group, whether it is military or in government sector also, everywhere this management word is applicable. And I would even say that since the time you are born and by the time you are going to die, it is management which is applicable everywhere, at every step of your life, at every stage of your life, in every phase of your life. Management is critical element in the economic growth of a country as well. And why it is? It is by bringing together the four factors of production. What resources we are saying, like in the third point we have said, men, money, material, machines. These enable a country to experience a substantial level of economic development. Any country which is with enough of capital, manpower, and other natural resources can still be poor if it does not have competent managers to combine and coordinate these resources. Merely having resources will not make you successful. In fact, managing those resources will make you successful. And there are generally four type of resources what we have. It is men, machine, material, and method. And men, that is your human being, is the most important resource, is the basic resource. Like what this point is saying, organization resources include men, money, machinery, and material. These four resources are the resources that needs to be managed. And once it is you have your expertise in managing your resources very well, you are going to be a very good manager. Concept of management is defined as the process of getting things done from others to achieve goals effectively and efficiently. Like I have used these two words, effectively and efficiently. What does they mean? And what is the basic difference between these two words? Now we'll see what is efficiently and what is effectively. Efficiently is to complete a task with minimum cost. And effectively, it is basically to complete the task on time. I have quoted the examples also here. Like you can see the first example, A got a task of construction of the flyover. The estimated target for the same is 1000 crores and A completed the construction of flyover in 900 crores. In this case, A worked efficiently. With minimum input, he gave the maximum output. He constructed the flyover, which was to be constructed in 1000 crores, but he constructed it in 900 crores. He saved the resources. He managed the resources so efficiently that he completed a task saving the resource. And what is effectively? It is basically to complete the task on time. For example, keeping in mind the above example only, A got 2 years time period for the construction of flyover. If A completes his task within the span of 2 years, in this case, we can say A's management is effective. What was required from him, he has done that, and it is just he proved himself to be effective only, not efficient. Efficient is where he has proved him out of the way, out of the box. What was not expected from him, but he proved, he did it in a positive manner. That is, he proved him efficient enough. And if it is you are giving, you are providing, you are producing that much only what is being expected from you, there you are proving yourself to be effective. And management is basically getting your work done from others, or it is achieving your goals either effectively or efficiently. And in fact, it could be effectively and efficiently as well. Now, what is the definition, or what are the definitions of management? Like what other people have defined management as? The very first definition was given by Mary Parker Follett. It is the art of getting things done through people. The second definition is by Frederick Winslow Taylor. He is also known as F.W. Taylor. He defined management as the art of knowing what you want to do in the best and cheapest way. Now, why the word cheapest is used in this definition? It is to be efficient. You are saving the resources. You are proving yourself to be efficient. What example we have quoted earlier of constructing the flyover in 1000 crores, but the person constructed it in 900 crores only. This is what? That you could do in the best and the cheapest way. George R. Terry defines management as a process consisting of planning, organizing, controlling, performed to determine and accomplish the objectives by the use of people and resources. Although people is also one of the resources, but here he has specifically mentioned people. Like people is something that couldn't be avoided, that you can't avoid in any situation or in any phase of your organizational objective or goal if you want to have that achieved. Your manpower is going to help you out with any other resource to achieve that particular objective. So specifically, he has mentioned that it is by the use of people and resources, you are going to accomplish your objective while having planning, organization, and controlling in hand. Now we'll discuss the nature of management. The very first nature of management, or very first point that defines the nature of management, is it is goal oriented. The main task of management is to achieve the goals of the organization. An organization has some goals, which are the basic reason for its existence. And what is a goal? Goal, it means what the organization wants to achieve. For example, for Reliance Jio, we have the example. It came up with a goal to capture whole telecommunication industry and to get the highest market share. Here in this example, the work of management is to achieve goals set by the Reliance geo with effectiveness and efficiency. The goal should be clear and simply stated to each member working for the organization. This is the very important point. Like whatever goal you are setting for your people to achieve, it should be very clear, very simple to understand that what we need to achieve. If you put some complicated goals before your people, before your workforce, they may not be able to understand what is that particular thing we are supposed to work for, what is that particular objective we are going to achieve or we shall achieve. It should be very clear. It should be very simple to understand. Easy to understand, I would rather say. So what nature of management says is that management is goal oriented. Until and unless you have a goal to achieve, for what you will manage the resources available. You are managing the resources available for a specific purpose. And what is that specific purpose? That is that goal, what you need to accomplish, what the objective that you need to achieve. The second, management is a group activity. It is not a one person activity. It is a group activity, and every individual working for the organization fully knows his responsibilities and duties which he or she is expected to achieve within the time allotted. Every individual joins the organization with different and multiple needs known as personal objectives, but works toward the achievement of organizational goals. It is a group activity. Once you are the part of an organization, basically what is organization? Organization is a group of people working together for a common objective, for a common goal. And once, so it is not your individual activity. It comes to be the activity of a group. So management is where you need to control, where you need to manage the resources available while working in a group, while working in a team. Therefore, we call it, yeah, we say that as the nature of management, management in itself is a group activity. The third point that we are going to discuss as the nature, this is management is an intangible force. Management cannot be touched or seen, but its presence can be observed if its objectives are achieved as per the set goal. The satisfaction of stakeholders is a guiding force of good management. The decision making of managers should be in the light of objectives to be achieved. And secondly, the implementation of such decisions, such target both efficiency and effectiveness. Management is something that is intangible. You cannot touch or see it, but you can feel its presence. You might have heard that many times we say that the things are very properly managed. He has or she has very, you know, managed things very nicely or very in a very planned manner. We say that it is because you can feel that, you know, arrangement of things, arrangement of resources, or you can say that it is something that you are feeling. You cannot see that things are managed, but you can feel it. You cannot touch management. You cannot see management, but you can merely feel its presence. Therefore, it is called management is an intangible force. Fourth point is management is all pervasive. Management is a pervasive function as it is applied to all kinds of organization. Irrespective of your nature, organizational nature, it is applicable to every organization. Like I said, it is applicable everywhere. You say it and you find it. It is applied in all types of organization irrespective of the following factors: size, purpose, level. Could be a small scale industry, medium scale or large scale industry. It could be a profit earning. It could be a non-profit earning organization. This could be a top level, middle level or lower level of organization. No matter what you come from or where you come from, but it is management is applicable everywhere. For example, the lower level does day-to-day planning. The middle level does departmental level planning. And the top level does organizational level planning. But you see that planning is applicable at all the levels of management. And what is planning? Planning is the first and the foremost function of management. That shows this example in itself proves that management is applicable at all the levels of the organization. And in the same manner, it is applicable in every organization itself. No matter what is the nature, what is the size, what is the purpose, or what is the level in your organization or of your organization, but management is everywhere applicable. The fifth point is management is multidimensional. It is a complex activity with three main dimensions: management of work, management of people, and management of operations. Now, what is management of work? Management of work aims to manage the work, that is, which work to be performed at what time, planning. Management of people includes management of individuals to allot authorities, responsibilities, and their duties. Managing people has two dimensions, management of individuals and management of people or management of group, you can say. Management of individual, it means dealing with employees as individuals with their diverse needs and behaviors. And for management of people, it means dealing with individuals as a group of people to maintain coordination among the individuals at the same level. Now, what is management of operations? It is interlinked with both management of work and management of people. When we'll combine these two things, then this will lead to management of operations. This has some basic products and services to provide in order to survive. For example, the main activity of bank is to provide loans and to take loans from the public. But they are providing other activities as well as online banking, ATM service at no cost, etc. You will see that it is not just you are managing simple one direction, one dimension of your organization. It is you are managing the entire organization in multi-dimensions, in diverse directions. You are working to manage the things. You are managing your work. You are managing your people. You are managing your operations. It is you cannot manage just a one thing. You cannot say that you'll just manage the people. You'll just manage the work, or you'll just manage the operations. You need to manage everything, every aspect, every phase, every part of your organization. You have to manage your work also. You have to manage your people also. And also you have to manage the operations that include both work and people. This is why we call or we say that management is multidimensional. The sixth is, it is a continuous process. Management is a process of continuous activities, but separate functions like planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. Management starts with the organization and ends with the organization. You cannot say that it is a one-time process. Once you have managed anything, now you need not to do anything. You need not to control. You need not to check anything. Or you need not to even manage anything further. It is not. It is you have to manage, or the organization is something that where the things need to be managed every time in a continuous process. And it includes planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. Once you are done with this planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling for one thing, for achieving one particular objective, you'll altogether start with this planning again, and you'll end up with the controlling. Then you'll start with planning. It is just a cycle, that planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling. And it goes on and on. The seventh nature of management is, it is a dynamic function. In order to survive, management should make changes according to the business environment. In order to ensure regular growth, managers should make changes in the policies as per the needs of the stakeholders. For example, Paytm is making the ventures with all types of business units such as schools, universities, and other companies and professionals to provide a single platform for all payment solutions. Now, in this competitive world, things are changing now and then. In this technological era, you know, every day you find something new, you see something new. And it is, if you need to be a part of this competitive world, you need to survive, you want to survive, your organization wants to survive in this world, then it is where you need to keep on changing. You need to see how to manage the things. And therefore, it is said that management is a dynamic function. You cannot manage the things in a single manner all the time. You need to change your pattern. You need to, it is the requirement of the society, or you can say it is the requirement of the scenario that you have to change accordingly. Otherwise, you will not even be surviving the competition and you will be failing off. Now we'll move on to the next topic. And the next topic is importance of concept of management, or we can say what are the significances of management. First, the very first significance is optimal use of resources. A manager eliminates wastage of resources that leads to efficiency in all business functions. If you will keep your things managed, if you will keep your resources managed, in that case, you are somewhat eliminating the wastage of the resources. If you are not planning something, if you are abruptly doing anything, you know, without any planning, without organizing anything, then it is you are wasting the resources that are available with you. But if you are managing, if you are properly keeping things managed, that means you are doing the optimum utilization of the resources. It is you are using your resources, or you are using the resources available in the best possible manner. That is the efficiency you are showing, and it is what we call at optimum use of resources. The second significance is effective leadership and motivation. It helps employees to work in harmony and achieve goals in a coordinated manner. It provides effective leadership and motivation for employees to work hard. If there is proper management, if you have things properly managed, that means you are somewhat and you are somehow motivating your staff. They'll be happy enough to be a part of such team, such organization that is well managed, well planned. But if you are not well planned, then the staff working with you may get frustrated, may get depressed, may get under pressure, or may feel tense at times because of unplanned activities that are happening. Because when you have your staff, they are putting in their efforts to achieve the organizational objective. But your objective is not very clear. Your things are not planned. You have not organized anything. They are putting in their efforts, but that is going in vain. Then that would lead to demotivation, or your staff will be demotivated. That will prove, yeah, that will show that you do not have any effective leadership in your organization. So it is necessary to have management, and we can say that management provides you, yeah, provides your staff a motivational spirit and effective leadership, so that whatever they are doing, whatever they want to do, whatever they are asked to do, they are doing it in the best efficient or effective manner, and they are doing it towards the achievement of the organizational objective. Sound industrial relations. Our manager maintains a balance between employees' demands and organizational needs, helping to reduce industrial disputes. Balance between need and demand, then it is you are maintaining somewhat peace, you are reducing the disputes in between. And this is what management does for the organization where it is properly implemented. Achievement of goals. It helps in realizing goals with maximum efficiency by minimizing unnecessary deviations, overlapping efforts, and waste motions. Improvement in living standards. It improves the standard of living of people by ensuring optimum utilization of scarce resources and survival of the firm in a dynamic environment. Establishing a sound organization. Managers help to establish a sound organization through effective authority and responsibility relationships. And the last significance is it reduces cost. A manager uses cost-effective techniques to reduce production cost and increase production. That is the optimum use of the resources. Efficiency, this is so. So these seven are the significances or the importance of the concept of management, why it is necessary to have things managed, or why it is important to have a managed or planned organization. So this is what we have studied so far in last half an hour. That is, what is management, concept or definitions of management, nature of management, and importance of management. Now we will start with the functions of management, and the five functions to start with, I'm just telling that those are planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. Now we'll start with the functions in detail. Thank you.